Hello! Welcome back to the Adventures of Dark Souls or Ryhnoking, aka Ryan. So basically, funny thing is, again. So funny thing is, had to not record certain parts because had trouble with it. So basically, don't worry, still haven't done a suicide run. But I did get a few things that you might be missed out, but nothing too major. So basically, I'm gonna just give this woman here my firekeeper sword, which I found. Found it in. So yeah. So you see that now. You see now. Basically, reinforced the SS flask. So now I can heal. I heal more when I drink. When I drink one of these, by hitting X. So yeah. So. On with the show. So basically, I'm gonna be less informative now, cause it's hard to be like certain parts just keep going missing. And I don't know why. So I'm just gonna try and be more entertaining. Yeah, fuck it. Ugh. But anyway, let's go down and do a little fun marathon, shall we? So yeah, blah, blah. So yeah, this game is, I really like this game. This is a very good game, in depth, a lot of fun gameplay, and the bosses too are challenging. That's what I like, a challenging boss, not one that's like very simple. Even when you like, you level up to a point where it's just like you think you're God, and it's just, nope, you ain't shit. So anyway, yeah, this is where we got the Firekeeper Soul before. I had went down that way. I can't remember where, if I can see it from here. But somewhere over there I got the Firekeeper. You see where that green light is? That's where I died. That's where I got it. So yeah, oh, there's a guy down here. He basically, this guy. Talk to him if you want to enchant your weapons with magic. But not gonna do that, so we're not for this playthrough anyway. So basically gonna go up here and use the master key to open up this back door. Back door to what? To a lot of things. One of the things that, like, in essence, one thing we gotta do is go this way, because this is, I'm gonna try something that I haven't done in any playthrough. So if I die, this is like literally a first run try. Alright, so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go past this what seem is a sleeping undead dragon. Yep. I am not in any way gonna try and fight this thing, because this thing will kill me. I'll come back for those items later. Hopefully if I don't die, but it's gonna kill me over here. Alright, because what I'm essentially doing here is suicide. So people, if you are just starting this game, do not do what I'm doing here. This is literally madness. What I'm doing here is extremely dangerous, and you will die. And I probably will die here, because I'm not even the best at this. Alright. Dodge him. Run past. Hopefully he is very slow. Seems like it. Run past his buddy here. Jump rope. Go over here. Over here. Over here. Hopefully they can't follow me. And let's go here. You're probably thinking, where am I going to? I have honestly no clue. This is just something I've seen on the internet. Been done. I always want to try to do this myself, so I'm just gonna take you through like first test tries here. So fingers crossed, I don't die. Don't want to light that bonfire yet. Don't really want to light that, cause it will get me killed. Okay. Oh god. Don't want to face him. Grass shield. See if I can. Oh no. Oh, I'm dead. Yeah. I should have gone right past them, but nope. Okay, I wanted to get a bow that's up there somewhere. Problem is, with him chasing me, it would have been hard to get. I can go back and do it again. Because I really want that bow. That bow is really good to have at the starting game. I think I'm going to give it a try, yeah. Let's give it another try. I might just cut this. I might just cut me getting better there again. Depends on what happens if I... Honestly, if I keep dying, sometimes dying can be, well, not dying, no, dying is never interesting, but basically, this, sometimes the game deaths and, like, seeing what kills you in this game is an interesting learning point for new players, so, but I think, see, I'm very indecisive with certain decisions. Let's just go and see how, I didn't hit the button. Let's see where this goes. Okay. Well, the thing is, I gotta go past that dragon again and get those items eventually. So, yeah. All right. Daddy of the Drakes. By the way, what those purple things that were shooting lightning from their mouths? That was Drakes. Pretty much, Drakes are like small dragons or fake dragons. I don't know which. I can never tell which. But in most, like, fantasy lore, like, they are, you know, they are, they're in pretty much most fantasy lore. Like, especially in, like, Magic the Gathering, if you play that game, which I do, I love that game. So, if you play Magic the Gathering, you'll find a lot of, like, cards, monsters and creatures that are pretty much like that. I keep calling the creatures in Magic the Gathering monsters. Because I used to play Yu-Gi-Oh! And I'm so used to calling them monsters. But I was told off one time. I was told off not to call them monsters, they were creatures. And funny enough, it was by a girl who told me to do this. Not a girl that I knew, but just a girl who I follow on Twitter, and she was just like, "Oh, but they're not monsters. They're called creatures." I won't name drop her out there like that. But she knows who she is. If she ever comes across this video, and she probably doesn't, because she probably doesn't even remember that conversation. To be honest, yeah, I have that way of girls. Like. Girls don't remember what I say. To be honest, I don't even remember what I say half the times. Oh god! That was, alright, that was bullshit. He knew I was coming. I dodged that just luckily. That was bullshit. Alright, Where's the item? Shit, where is it? Because he's gonna follow me. Is it up here? It's up here. Alright, he's gonna follow. He's not gonna stop. Basically, these guys do not stop following you. Alright, which is it? No, not there. I don't think it was there. Oh, wait, no, he is stopping. He's going back. Or maybe he's lost. Okay. Okay. Alright, reason I'm getting that is it's Crystal Lizard. It's like a... It gives you like a... Basically Titanite, which you use to upgrade your tools. Your, like, equipment, weapons and stuff. So basically, if you find them, kill them. Quickly, because they actually disappear. They do respawn back once you hit the bonfires. But that's only if you hit the bonfires. And they don't respawn... And you can't, like, farm them. So don't try and, like, kill it and come back to it. Because it doesn't respawn. That was a non-respawnable enemy. Alright, I went too far. Because... There's enemies here that I'm not prepared to fight at the moment. Because I'm too low level. So, Trying to find the item. can't remember where it is. If I remember correctly. And if I remember correctly, it's somewhere. Oh, is that it? That's probably it down there. Is that another crystal lizard? Because I remember there's two crystal lizards here. Well, there's the body of the one I killed. Yeah, you can play football with their bodies. Hopefully that knight is not down there. Because that was a silver knight. They mess you up badly. Okay, oh, here it is. This is where I gotta go. Alright, that's what I wanted, the longbow. Saves me from using souls to buy a bow from a merchant that we'll meet later. So basically, that is... Alright, so that's what I came here for. I wonder if I can make a quick suicide run. You know what, let's go out of style. Because basically I want to get back to the bonfire now because I got the item. Or maybe if I can... Oh, maybe I can... No, I won't be able to run to... I won't be able to get that ring yet, so... Can't kill that creature that's in the way. Or maybe I can skirt past it. Ah, you see, this is the problem with this game. There's like so many routes you can take. That you're not supposed to take, but you can still like... You can like run past them and take them. Basically just be a humongous coward. No, I won't get it. I'll just die with honor. Go out like a man. Alright, so basically what I'm going to do is I'm going to go over here. Because the thing is, I'm certain other players would be able to get this ring that I want to get. But I'm not the best player at the moment. Oh wait, I can't even open this door, can I? Oh, I can! Alright. Wanna move. Because he's right there. Now, this guy is Havel the Knight. Havel the Rock, sorry, not the Knight. And you see that? Now, the funny thing is, he is in the bottom of the level that I need to go to. And I probably won't kill him. I'm probably gonna die by him in a minute. Because I need him to attack me. So I can go for the backstab. Alright, you see that having light items helps you, but in this case, it's doing nothing to him. Because I'm too low of a level. My items are not strong enough as well. It's doing literally like pips of damage. And he don't know why he jumped back there. Oh god. Oh no. I seem to move faster with my shield up. Which is weird. Okay, I need him to move. Okay, so far he's not hitting me, so that's good. Okay, he nearly hit me there. Alright, you see that? You see how much he took out of my stamina? It's because I'm too low level. My shield is not powerful enough to take that hit. Well, that's it. Yeah, she is quite powerful enough to take that hit. But if it was... And the fact that I have taken off all my stuff has made me a little bit faster. And able to survive this. And the fact that I'm still surviving this is amazing. Because the first time I fought this guy, I died like so badly. This guy just like wrecked me. He wrecks a lot of like new players very quickly. And he got instantly back up there. So basically what you want to do is, like with enemies like this, you want to skirt around them and keep your shield up. keep your shield up. Because your shield can save you. I'm lucky that right now he's just using probably one of the most slowest weapons. Not the slowest, but a very slow weapon. Makes it easier for me to skirt around him. Oh! And he nearly got me there. He nearly got me. Oh. And for some reason, he jumped back up. Oh god, move back. Because then he would kill... You see, that would kill me. And for... because of the fact that I'm skirting around him, the camera moves... It's the camera in rotation with the movement. I'm actually doing okay, but I'm not going to... Oh, you see, he's moving back against the stairs. Alright. He's going to move back there. Okay. I wonder if I can quickly two-hand it. Oh god! Okay, that was nearly... Okay, he nearly... Alright, don't wanna keep rolling. My hands are actually super sweaty, so I'm frightened that the controller's gonna slip from my hands. I really am, because I'm doing well and I don't wanna... I don't want to make a blunder. And you're probably thinking, would magic be any better? No, it wouldn't. This guy is pretty much anti-magic. Because the lore about this guy is, he hates magic with a passion. To the point where he created a spell. He created a magic, a miracle. Specially made to make him more defensive against magic. And his armor and whatnot is like used. Oh, okay, he faked me out there. His armor is literally, he made it specially tailored to tank magic. To pretty much tank everything. Including backstabs, look at that. Backstabs are pretty much critical hits and he is like just tanking it like a boss. Havel, man. You gotta respect. I mean, he's crazy. He went hollow. That's the reason why he's down here. But you know, he's the original. He is like the bossiest character you can. Alright, see again, because I overstepped my boundaries. He nearly killed me. Right, I'm not gonna. No, I'm not gonna put my shield down. I'm not gonna two-hand it at all, I'm not gonna risk it. He seems to be stuck there. I think I glitched him there just a minute ago. Once again, he won't move back. Don't know why he did that. Okay. And if you ask, yes, you can get his armor set, but not until later in the game. You reach a certain point, which I do plan to get to. Oh, nearly messed it up there. Nearly messed it up. Alright, is he dead? No, he's not dead. And, alright. Now, you see that thing, spirit, that ghost you see? That's another player. Oh, okay, he's getting... Alright, he's getting desperate because he's putting up his shield now. He put up his shield because he knows he's low on health. And I killed him! Oh my god, I killed him! Oh my god! That's the first time I've killed him at this low of a level. Oh my god. Oh shit. I got the Havel ring so early. Oh, that's amazing. That's amazing. Yes. Okay, now. Actually, if I can go up here, that... I pretty much made a shortcut for myself, because the Underberg is where we had to head to, but we would have taken a slightly different path. Oh my goodness. And hopefully this doesn't break the game if I do this. If I can come out this way. Because there's a door here, and... Oh! It opens! And I can sneak up on this guy. This is the first time I've done this. Because normally I would come through that way that guy's coming, which leads me through basically a bunch of enemies. Oh my goodness. Okay. That is super new. Alright, now, this is interesting now. Okay, so basically I'm at the place I need to get to. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna put back on all my stuff. Oh, and I don't wanna die now because I killed him, I got all his souls. Ooh, and the problem is yeah. So I'm gonna play it very safe here because I don't wanna die now. Because normally when you go on suicide runs, that's the point, you get your item and you die. But because I've already gotten the item and I've killed someone who I didn't think I was able to kill. Yeah. And these guys are gonna be a little bit of a hassle now because I aggro both of them. Oh wait, no. Okay, this guy. All right, this guy. If I can separate them and kill them off one by one, it'll be easy for me. Easier for me. Oh shit. Or if I can just get them here. Oh, I got them both. Oh, that's brilliant. Okay. Okay, sorry, I went quiet there for a minute because this is literally the first time I've done this. Like this. Normally I would always come up through this way. And this is the first time I've done this. Okay. I've done it backwards. So. Alright, so. Okay. Oh, bloody hell. And normally I would have already killed that guy. Okay, oh, thank goodness, I was worried there. I was worried that headshot would have been some form of critical that would have screwed me. I have a beautiful game at the moment. Oh, ho, 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 ho. Okay, so, yeah, this is really new for me now. I mean, I've done this before, but usually I would have killed most of these guys coming that way, down that stairs. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go up here. Hopefully none of these guys see me. I can just kill these guys. I want to backstab this guy before his mates come here. Oh god, oh! And he dropped there. Oh! And as you see, even though I blocked, I still got damage. Because certain types of damage can break through shielding. Mainly things like magic, fire, and lightning. Magic is one of the more annoying things because they seem to do like the most, like just bypassing defenses, like shielding. Unless you have a weapon or tools and items that can help you block magic. Oh ho, this is the first because normally I would have to. That guy opened the door and he's coming through the outside. Can I go through this? I can. Oh crap. Oh, I shouldn't have opened that. Okay, yeah, this is really new territory and very scary. Because normally I would be talking because I'd be confident in what I'm doing. And be able to talk and play at the same time because I know what I'm doing. But now I've come to a point where I'm just... Why do I keep hearing footsteps? Or is that my own footsteps? It's my own footsteps, isn't it? See, I'm going paranoid now because I'm so worried about dying. Although, at least if I die here, I'm closer to the bonfire which I need to go to. No, someone else is walking. It's not my imagination. I hear someone else's footsteps. Okay, what I'm gonna do is... Okay, so what I'm gonna do here is... I'm gonna ignore these guys. Oh, no, can't. I was gonna try and ignore them. Let's go to the bonfire, which is right there. But that guy beat me to the punch. That guy, is he coming? Oh, it doesn't matter, because he's stuck. So I'm just gonna hit the bonfire. Oh no, he got here too quickly. Basically, I can't rest at the bonfire if there's an enemy here, close by. Well, now there isn't, so time to rest. And time to level up, because, oh god, that was so amazing. Because normally, that guy is very hard to beat, and the fact that I beat him quite simply, well, not very simply, it's like a long process. But the fact that I did it around the first time at that low of a level, because normally I've had a few souls here and I'd have leveled up. Oh, my heart is pacing. You see, if you could touch my chest right now, you would feel my heart beating. Okay, so I'm gonna put some more points of vitality. Always good. Endurance is really good. Strength also a must. Yeah, so basically, because I want to keep these three stats even up as possible. I will probably put some more stats in faith later on when I get more souls and probably more capsulated souls. So yeah, I think that's good for now. Yeah. Okay. So I'm gonna go a little backwards here because there are things behind me that I should have got that I didn't, so bear with me. Because technically where I need to go is where I just came from, so... Not the bottom part, but like, there's more at the top of the staircase, so... Of that tower we were just in. So, yeah. Oh! Unequip those. And equip Havel's ring. Now what this does is it boosts, what rings do they give you, like rings have like certain items, like sorry, certain abilities. This one it boosts like equip load, so basically, my equip stat, where is it? No, yeah there is. Equip load, which is usually right below the stamina, it tells me, it basically increased that, so basically I'm able to carry more with and fast row now, as you can see. Increasing stamina does help that. Like with fast rowing, but items really help big with it. So, and as you see, these enemies are back. Like I said, enemies get revived. Oh god. Oh, that's a huge one. You probably can't tell, but I did do a little bit more damage there. Also, interesting note, if you hit them during certain animations, you'd actually do more damage to them. Because, I don't know why. You'll have to look it up, where basically, like, during certain animations, you do more damage. But it's a known fact that it does. So, if you hit them during a certain animation, like the end of certain animations, you just clip them, it does more damage. Voila. So now... There's your safety tip for the day. But, actually, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna kill this guy. Oh, that's another thing you can do. If you hit forward and attack, forward and RB, kick, which kicks away the shield. But I think I'm going to stop here, and I'll come back and go for a break. Remember, remember, friends. So, you know, comment this video. Say hello, just hello, or say something. Say hi, how you doing? Or say you're playing this game all wrong. You went backwards. I know I went backwards, but I can't help it. It was fun. But yeah, comment the video, like it, helps out. Subscribe to my channel, really helps out. Means you like my stuff, you want to see more. I love giving more. So do that, and I will be back with you shortly. Let me wave. Oh, that's no. Goddamn, wrong one. All right, there we go. Kiss.